Respect the DJ. Respect the DJ with DJ Swift.
Hey, DJ!
Yeah, boy!
Yes, you're not tuning to DTF Radio on.
Respect the DJ.
Respect the DJ
with DJ Swift.
We got a dope segment for y'all today, y'all. Big shout out to the homie Skanks in the building, y'all. Shout out to Fred. Remember, we IG live. Remember, we live, y'all.
She doesn't treat you the way you want her to.
Yes.
So come on, stop running. I want
big shout out to Fresh, shout out to Fresh, shout out to Fresh, shout out to Fresh.
But your girl don't know what hurt her. Anything to make this love go further.
You're the one.
You're
Strictly Quest Blends.
DJ Quest.
A quick blend, you know how I go. Big shout to No Beliefs in the building, y'all. On IG. My bad. Shout out to Trey Love in the building, y'all. Just messing around, y'all. Warm me up. Hold up. Nah, this ain't the version you think this is.
DJ Quest.
That's right, y'all. Strictly Blends.
I know how it feel to wake up, bust up, pockets.
Big shout out to Willie Benz in the IG check-in.
No, people look at you.
What up, my brother?
You use a selling drugs to all the losers, mad.
DJ Quest.
Respect the DJ.
The DJ.
With DJ Swift.
Way mad bills to pay. That's why you drink Tangerine. So you can reminisce and wish you wasn't living so devilish.
What?
I remember I was just like you, smoking blunts with my crew, flipping over 62s. Cause GED wasn't B-I-G. I had to get P-A-D. That's why my moms hate me. She was forced to kick me out, no doubt. Then I figured out, Knicks went for 20 down south. Packed up my tools for my raw power move. Glock 19 for casket and flower moves. But Trump's trying to stop my flow. And what they don't know will show on the autopsy. Went to see Poppy to cop me a brick. Asked for such a sign and he wasn't trying to hear it. Smoking mad Newports cause I'm doing court for an assault that I caught in Bridgeport, New York. Catch me if you can like the gingerbread man. You better have your gat in hand cause man.
I got some new tracks, exclusive tracks about to play.
Cash rules everything.
Respect the DJ with DJ Swift. Each and 6 to 7 p.m. Let's go. DG girl live out.
Everyone falls in love sometimes. I don't know about you, but it ain't a crime. Let me love you, love you, love you, love you for a long time, baby. Let me touch and let me love you till the morning.
Respect the DJ. The DJ with DJ Swift.
New music!
Yeah.
the homie Dope Beliefs.
Club, look.
What up, my brother?
Pull up to the club, post it with the club. When my shoulder's bad, I don't want to.
Shout out to Queen's Finest, Inc.
Pull up to the club.
My Diddy, Queen's Finest.
Pull up to that. If it ain't a bag, I ain't showing.
Queen, let's go.
Pull up to the club, post it with the club.
Pull up to that.
All these niggas mad, why they act?
DJ Quest.
Pull up to the club, post it with the club.
Pull up to that.
You ain't.
Shout out to my comrade, DJ Butch Rock.
If I'm at the spot, then it's bottles on me. If I'm pulling up, then I'm looking OD. If she giving top, then you know I'm on C. And if she about to stop, then you know I gotta leave. Nigga, look at me.
Bring this back one more time.
Yeah.
This is my homie, Dope Beliefs.
Shorty, fuck.
The club final mix.
Look.
D-O-P-E-B-E-L-I-E-F-S. Let's go.
If I'm at the spot, then it's bottles on me. If I'm pulling up, then I'm looking OD. If she gets tired, then
stop. Respect the DJ. DJ with DJ Swift.
DJ Quest.
Driving my own lane. Whatever you say, got my own way. Catch me at the spot where them hoes stay.
Let's do this.
Be right there, like where we just never fight fit. Don't care, tight stick. Copy what I might wear. Flex it though. Heard your shorty made in Mexico. She got you half a bottle. Got it.
Oh, love, my brother.
Let it go. Swear y'all need a lesson. Y'all should see my section. Not a lot of tension. We ain't even mentioned. Church after the party to receive a blessing. If I got the club, I ain't never stressing. Pull up to the club, post it with the club. On my shoulders bad, I don't want no love. Pull up to the club, post it with the club. If it ain't a bag, I ain't showing up. Pull up to the club.
I'ma let this joint rock out.
All these niggas mad, why they acting up? Pull up to the club, post it with the club. You ain't fucking with us, but fuck up. If the whole team on the scene is a movie, we on the act, we afraid the movie. Couple of them ride with us, so they got their duty. Heard your girl a slide, so I fucked in
DJ
my
Quest.
Respect the DJ, DJ, the DJ Swift.
By your girl in tights, I fucked up all
DJ
the bosses.
Quest.
I'ma let you in here, but it's kinda crowded.
Yeah.
The boss will try to dub you, but I ain't allow it. He like, I ain't mean to. VIP the only thing the team do. Fabby right behind me, he directing when the scene moves. You just came in, don't think you got poppin'. Little homie, try to stop it, never even seen. I don't wanna hear niggas asking me what's up. No, gotta spread the word, man, a fuck with me's a luxury. Niggas wasn't looking for me, now they looking up to me. Check chances if you talking to me, nigga, you.
This shit's fire, y'all.
Pull up to the club, post it with the club.
I'm not just saying it to my homie.
My shoulder's bad, I don't want no love. Pull up to the club, post
it. Yo, Dope Beliefs, everybody in the studio saying it's fire too, bro.
Bag, I ain't showing up. Pull up to the club, post it with the club.
Pull up to
the. All these niggas mad.
Big shout out to Debonair.
Pull up to the club, post it with the club.
Pull up to the.
You ain't f- with it, then you fuck.
Set the beat down, we fucking giving.
Big shout out to Skanks in the building, baby.
Down, we fucking giving.
AK the rap Martier, if I said it right.
Check the beat down, we fucking, fucking, fucking.
Marta, ah man, I fucked that up.
Check the beat down, we
shout out to Skanks, the rap Marta, that's your gal.
We like fuck rapping, where I'm from. Dudes out with they fool to his gun, and the guns clapping. They wet you up, don't let shit slide. Old friends will set you up, some are switch sides. Start killing the same niggas I play tag with. That means fuck niggas. Anybody could get it. We hard body, we with it. We done stuck niggas. Army for T's on the jumps, a champion hood. All black chuckers, bitch, I be with the crooks.
DJ Quest.
I heard you popping the wrong way. One false move, you'll get popped on the block in a good day. Feeling hot, it's no mistake when you slunk.
Big shout out to my boy Richie, I'm an IG check-in.
Come
on, follow me on IG, Snapchat, Twitter, at the original DJ Quest.
Terminator, put on the sleeve, everything is real, so
I get it in and come apart on the beat.
Big shout out to my aunt who's actually on the IG check-in. What up, Titi Valerie?
It's Brooklyn, of course, you lost.
Even family checks in.
Valentine, come with them flows, he gets busy. Y'all cats talking about Chirac cities, but y'all know when it comes to the falls who rock with me. And three in Boston, I sell ticks, but ain't Bill Russell. Keep missiles that destroy bones, fuck tearing muscle. Live life in a hustle, knuckle up and I crush you, been there. These cowards wanna pull.
Oh, we got a lyricist, huh?
That's why I bust at your face before you see me in the tussle. Seen it all, shootouts in broad day. Bodies in streets, lobbies are holes, what you eyeing me for? Fuck that.
Remember, you're not soon to respect the DJ with DJ Swift.
Neck to your toe, shatter it all. General,
DTRadio.com.
Out in the ocean, niggas is raw. Weak as hell, then they put the albums in stores. I sit back, then I laugh, puff for Ella ignore like fuck rapping.
Amen. 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 Let us bow our head, amen, for these unfortunate MCs.
Good night.
Dearly beloved, we get the lit today. Today these whack niggas to rest. Now let us bow. Today the ladies whack niggas to rest. Now let us bow. Today the ladies whack niggas to rest. Now let us. Today the ladies whack niggas to rest. Now let us bow our heads and pray. I got nothing good to say. It's no way to run and dodge. We coming hard at you, frost. Beware this part of card. Card. Yup, you trashing. Say it.
Shout to Skanks.
True MC like my crew with me. This a whack rapper eulogy. The whack, so whack, eulogy.
Is he in the name of charity and goodwill? Shepherds the weak through the valley of darkness.
Respect the DJ. DJ Swift.
Bacon is blatant, they pray to Satan, but they disguise it as money making. The mind's gym wouldn't allow these pigs. But
DJ Quest
ain't even Muslim, and I still can't trust them. These rappers slash moving keys through customs. They a dime a dozen, seen it all, heard it all before. That bullshit turned me into a matador.
We went from self-destruction till it's all above the Benjamins. All types of stereotypes and negative images. Ramadan, these drama's rhymes, they lyrics the equivalent of pork chops and chitlins.
But like a map, we got time for one more.
Get off that bullshit, they feeding us, man, it's all
bullshit.
It is mentally confusing.
I got you, Skanks.
Keep our destiny deluded. You'll eventually end up in a penitentiary, cemetery, or mental institution. Don't
do it. And I will strike down upon thee with great vengeance and furious anger.
This shit deserves gunshots. Fire! Yo, remember when you heard this shit first? Remember when you heard this shit first?
Welcome, respect the DJ, DJ with DJ Swift.
Pain, this is the worst. If you ain't on my side, boy, you better be chillin'.
Yo, Skanks, that New York shit.
From this heat.
Ah, man.
Drop UFC, ball, Super Bowl shit. NBA All-Stars,
DJ Quest.
No win, it's the fan. Rap your shit, I rap mines. Who the hell said Lil Kenny won't lose his mind? Reveal. Oh shit, just imagine that.
Remember to follow me on IG, that's the original DJ Quest.
Plane, flying to France. Ready
y'all
to
remember to follow Skanks on IG, y'all for real.
I stand, we the kings.
S-K-A-N-K-S, the rapper Marty Earl.
Yeah.
I'm fucking up the last part. The rap martyr.
Hands up.
Hands
up.
Oh, flow professional, my man.
Pussy feeling bad at him, nobody not been. I came up with thinking of you.
Google him, fuck that.
Hands up. Can you like hands up?
Respect the DJ. DJ.
Not that one,
DJ Swift.
Not that one, yeah. Not that pussy won't be here. Chatting that you did. Not that one, yeah.
Big shout out to Terrell, I'm an IG checking.
Not that pussy won't be here. Chatting that you did. This pussy feeling bad, but me not bad. Me just a man.
that's modern, sick up in me head, cause he be dead me, let me rock it. Woo. I should pour this straight from Pakistan. Skanks the man, bitches have to glance to get the chance.
You're not too chillin', respect the DJ with DJ Quest.
On some G shit, it's only G's that I
eat. Five on the set, yours truly DJ Quest.
Niggas can keep a secret. No bitches want the...
Jarrell, what up, my brother?
Russia come between us, back up there, my squad the meanest. We converted non-believers, we rap Avengers. Brooklyn,
big shout to Mr. Belly.
Killing all this mementos and murdering rap pretenders. I don't know if it's the Molly lines, we the leading drinking that got him thinking he tough, cause when I see him, I be thinking.
Who's he feeling bad at him? Now I came up, be thinking I am here. Hands up, kill your life, hands up. Who's that, you know, gangster? Who's he feeling bad at him? Now I came up, be thinking I am here.
Check him on IG.
Whoa.
Now for the interview.
Whoa. That's what I'm talking about. That's what I'm talking about. Big shout, DJ Quest, man. I see you doing your thing. As always, my brother DJ Quest always puts it down for us. What's going on, y'all? You are now watching Respect the DJ with me, DJ Swift, in the building live here on DTFRadio.com. We're also live on that DTF Radio mobile app. You can also catch us streaming live on that ustream.tv/DTF Radio. Understand that there's a theme going on here with DTF Radio. And we are also live streaming as well on that www.thevandalhour.nyc. And for those that don't have a laptop or you don't have none of those apps on your phone, you can catch yourself or you can find yourself watching us on
my IG
DJ
page.
Quest's very own IG Live.
Shout
on the original DJ Quest on IG. We are live and direct on there, man. We're trying to get all these platforms. Yeah, we're going to get a few more laptops. We're going to get a few more tablets. And then we're going to be on damn near every platform. It's going to be like Channel 2, 4, 5, 7, 9, yeah, 11, VH1, and all that good stuff. But back to what I like to talk about here on Respect the DJ. We respect the DJ, the turntablist, the mixer, the master. The mixer, the master, the scratcher, the cutter, the mood setter, the beat catcher, a.k.a. the foundation. We call that the disc jockey here in this thing that we love called hip-hop. But now you already know, I already spoke live about him. I got my brother DJ Quest on the side supplying us with the music. I got a great show lined up for y'all right about now. I got a fly MC sitting next to me for those that are watching. This man is hailing from Brooklyn, and he's been doing a few big things here in New York City, himself and his camp. I just can't say it, him by himself, but everybody in the building, put your hands together for my man Skanks, a.k.a. the Rap Martyr. Boop, 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 boop. You know what I mean? That's my guest in the building, but his brethren is sitting here alongside us. Now, I want to make sure I say your name correctly. It is Blue
Bear.
Bear.
Yeah.
Blue Bear.
Yeah, facts.
Okay, so once again, we're going to start this all over again. Put your hands together for motherfucking Blue Bear in the building. Bankai Camp. Bankai in the building. This is how we doing it. Just so that everybody know, Skanks is live. Right about now, is that on your IG or is that?
Yeah. You can follow us live right now on the Bankai Hour.
Bankai Hour.
Yeah.
Are we live and direct?
I got you. Good
we live on the Bankai Hour as
we
well.
Live on every platform. Today.
That's right.
Yeah,
that's right.
We live all over the place.
This is what you call cross marketing.
Like Facebook Live and shit about.
Right? Nah. We got them in a minute. They got too many legal issues going on with the government. I'm gonna fall back from that real quick. Everybody say that's the way to go, but I'm going to be easy with that. I'm going to wait till everybody tell me that the coast is clear. The smoke is gone. But right about now, this is when we start talking about some of the hot topics and current events that's been going on.
Yeah.
I just want to talk about, since we got MCs in the building, How do y'all feel about these MCs passing away? We had another one pass away, and this time it wasn't even from violence. It was, I gotta say, self-inflicted violence. You know what I mean? We had Mac Miller, you know what I mean, pass away from an alleged drug overdose.
Word.
You know, condolences to his family and his camp. You know what I'm saying? That's a hard thing for anybody to have to, you know, stomach.
Word.
But what are y'all take on these guys wilding out on doing all these drugs and stuff, thinking that that's the wave?
It's like, yeah, it's kind of bugged out to me. Like, I never got with the this new wave of the generation. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I was a strictly herbal, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Henny dude coming
oh,
up.
Oh, nah, we definitely
youth,
420 you know friendly here at Respect the DJ. We always show love with that, you know what I mean?
But all the other extra stuff, like, I never was able to get into that, you know what I'm saying? Like, you know, shout out legends like, you know what I'm saying, like Pimp C, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Like, cause like, shout out my cousins from Texas back in the 90s. They been was putting me on, telling me about the pro meth, all that shit. But it just wasn't my lane, you know what I'm saying? Like,
right.
I remember so far back, my cousin used to sneak them shits over in Fruitopia bottles, lean in Fruitopia bottles on the plane.
I remember those. Listen, I mean, lean is not something new.
Yeah.
I mean, if you listen to hip hop since the late 90s, early 2000, you already know about 3-6 Mafia sipping on some scissor.
Word.
You already know about Dipset had a champagne, you know, bandwagon over there called scissor.
Facts.
You know what I'm saying? I mean, it was at a point that Chopped and Screwed basically is off the essence off of that lean lifestyle. You know what I mean? So this is nothing new. This is nothing new of the effects of it. You know, now I'm not too sure if that's what Mac Miller, you know, passed away from. But
overdose,
but you know, like even with those pills and all that lifestyle, I gotta honestly say, you know, definitely from being from New York, weed was really the slowest thing, you know, anything that was going to slow you down, that was the only thing you really wanted to do, or it was Henny, you know what I'm saying? It was that dark liquor,
you know what I'm saying?
Because real talk, the New York pace or the up north pace was so fast.
Hustle
that
and bustle.
You didn't want to be lagging because you was like, dogs, you like a crackhead. Like, you was looked at as being like, nah, I'm not rocking with you.
Yeah,
like, you on that other wave. You on a whole nother wave, to whereas nowadays, that's the move, and they trying drugs. I mean, I even try to tell people, like, when you eating edibles, stop taking that title medical grade for light.
They're not
realizing, you know what I'm saying, medical grade edibles is made for people who have chronic pain, you know, from cancer, you know, multiple sclerosis.
Yep.
These people got a high threshold, and you wondering why you eating a small piece. And like you just eat a piece of a chocolate bar and you laid out for the day.
Word.
And you got nothing but horror stories.
They,
you know what I mean?
They tolerance for that pain make them be able to take a certain amount. And they know what the amount that they should take daily. You know what I'm saying?
You know what I'm saying? Because
you're
just
coming abusing. Like,
they use that for functioning.
Yeah.
They're not even getting high off of that.
Word.
And then, you know, you got people, and that's not even a harmful thing.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Word. And people are going around, you know, messing around with these, you know, pills and all these wild, crazy things. And I'm like, yo, y'all on a whole nother wave right now. I'm like, I like to have fun.
Yeah.
I like to have fun, but we ain't going to sit on that too long. But speaking about 420, what about Cynthia Nixon running for, what is it, governor, if I'm not mistaken, or mayor?
Governor.
Governor, right? Cynthia Nixon from Sex and the City. Is running for governor, and she's trying to legalize weed.
Yeah, I heard about that
in
too.
New York City. But I like the motion of some of these politicians right now. I mean, I'm not trying to sound like a total pothead. I am. I condone all 420 activities, but
it's not live strip club Swift.
Yeah, come on now. I'm more 420 happy than I'm strip club Swift. But I think it's a great thing because she's trying to expunge marijuana police records. You know, people who have marijuana charges or was locked up or have anything that's hindering against them for being arrested or having police contact because of marijuana. She feels that, like, yo, y'all are literally hurting the Black and Hispanic, you know, communities.
Yeah, she right, too.
You know, and it's true. And it's true, you know, being that we're from them, we see the effects firsthand. You know what I'm saying? We definitely see the effects of that firsthand. But I had a couple of other things that I really wanted to talk about.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm going to toss that aside because we got Skanks in the building from the Bankai camp. And we're going to talk about what Skanks and who Skanks is. So we're going to jump right into that. And
What's up, bro?
My man, like, for those that don't know here on Respect the DJ, can you let them know who is Skanks, a.k.a. the Rap Martyr?
What up, y'all? It's your boy, the Flow Fessional, Skanks the Rap Martyr, a.k.a. Master Norbert Torbert. Nobody bombs harder than Bankai Fam, Fifth and Sparta, and one half of Stone and Robin.
Mm.
Yeah.
Damn, he gave a better intro for his damn self than I could give on my own show. Damn. So, I know you're from Brooklyn.
Crime Heights.
What got you into doing hip-hop? Because you're an MC first and foremost.
Yeah.
You have a radio show. You have the Bankai Camp, right? Bankai Camp?
Yep.
Correct,
Bankai
right?
Bankai Fam.
Bankai Fam.
Yeah.
Y'all have your platform, but who is Skanks? What got you into this movement?
Yeah, I gotta give all credit to my big bro Golds, you know what I'm saying, and his partner Self. Like, they started a studio in the back room in my mom's crib back in the days, and like Clark Kent used to come through and DJ, Trackmasters, Dos Effects did their first demo that got them their deal, you know what I'm saying?
Wow.
Most Def and Talib.
Yeah.
Word, they was down there all the time. Foxy Brown, Spragga Benz, all these people was like,
you
down
had
there
Brooklyn.
On a regular.
You had the
word,
Brooklyn,
word.
Like 90s Brooklyn in there.
And I was like the little dude, like I was like 9, 10, just watching and absorbing all that. Like I used to get kicked out the studio mad times, chased out, yo, what your little ass doing here? Get out of here, yo, we smoking, yo, get your little ass. But then one day, running out the studio, I dropped my little rhyme book and they picked that shit up and they read this shit like, oh shit, little bro got some shit. Like, and then after that, they just started putting me in the studio, and then
so wait,
I did my first show.
That was your brother who found it, or was one of the MCs that found it?
It was in the studio. It was his partner, little bro, Omar.
Okay.
Yeah, who was like a good friend of mine to this day, man. But
that's what's up.
He put it on to all of them, like, yo, y'all bugging. Y'all keep chasing this little dude out the room. Y'all hear what he writing? Y'all see what he doing over here? And then it was history after that.
So with that, you could call yourself, like, you could basically say you was a studio rat.
Yeah, yeah.
He's a studio rat.
Like,
you know?
I was Jim Rat's little
dude.
Yeah,
I was just about to say, for those who don't know what a studio rat is, and ain't nobody snitching about what goes on in the studio. It's really someone who you cannot get out of the studio.
Word.
They are always there, whether you shut the lights off or you turn them on. He's there somehow, some way. He's like,
exactly.
Why are you here? You're like the custodian. Do something. You know what I mean? So with that, that's a great introduction into what is hip hop. You know what I mean? I mean, all the people that you named literally are or were influential people in this game to this day.
Word.
So now with that, seeing that type of caliber, what did that make you feel about how your rhyme style or your rhyme flow had to be?
I just knew I had to be like hard. Like when I came out as a little kid, you know, I was just absorbing everything from all the different people around me.
Mm-hmm.
But I knew if anything, I had to have balls. This was my first thing coming out. Like, I gotta say stuff that make people go, oh,
wow factor. You gotta get the wow factor.
That's my first time. So my brothers and them took me to my first show, you know what I'm saying? And it was a talent show. And like, I came in second place, if I'm not mistaken.
Mm-hmm.
I came in second place, but DJ Scratch approached me that day for a deal, and another lady that worked at BMI Records, not BMI Records, BMI Publishing, approached me about hooking me up with BMI and getting me into some shows. This when I was like 11, and then like from
wait a second, you had Scratch and a publisher, a representative of a publishing company coming to you already at 11.
Word.
God damn it, we got another reason why people keep on saying things all humbly, like every 11-year-old is doing that. They barely able to fucking walk themselves to school at that age, and you getting approached for deals and stuff. That's what's up. So go ahead.
Yeah, man. So you
gotta let them know, man. Yo, you're doing an interview. Why they calling you live? Why you doing an interview?
You know why though? That's like somebody trying to tell me something. I know what they trying to tell me. They don't know.
Yo, shout me out, dog. Shout me out, son. I see you on all platforms. But go ahead, continue as you were saying. You had the representative come at you.
And like, you know, like just me being young at the time and not really knowing who DJ Scratch was, you know what I'm saying? Like, I went with the lady, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
But she hooked me up. She hooked me up with a lot of things as a kid. Like, my first ever show that I did with her, I opened up with, we was rocking with Leaders of the New School, Brand Nubians, Poor Righteous Teachers. I remember, like, Ice-T held me up in the air, like, yo, this little dude is ill. He don't need no dances, no gimmicks, not like. And I got my name that day, Problem Child from Rampage, because Busta and Rampage approached me. Busta was like, Shorty, you the illest I ever heard. And then Rampage like, nah, you a Problem Child. And I just ran with the name after that.
Wow.
That's I didn't even
big.
Have a name at the time. My name was like MC Rowe.
MC Rowe. Right. That's a definite name of just getting thrown in a situation.
Word.
Like, they were like, yo, you could do this. We'll worry about everything afterwards. You know what I mean?
That's exactly what happened. That's exactly how it went down. They like, we going now. And
that's
then,
what's
like,
up.
All the other stuff came, like, you know, organically.
So all this is while you're 11 years old?
Yeah. And then I got a write-up in Rolling Stone magazine. I got the article on my wall to this day, like with I think it's what, Bart Simpson on the cover.
I better see that tomorrow on Throwback.
I got
on Throwback Thursday. I want to see that. I want to see that. I'll hold you to that.
Just for you, I got
you. Yeah, I want to see that. Tag me on that.
And no lie, word, I am. And like that article, I was the only person out of all the people I just named that actually got mentioned in the article. You know what I'm saying?
Wow.
Word.
That's big. So now, being that you had an early start to what the industry is, you know, as for doing shows, being in the studio, being around people that literally everyone was trying to jump over and do anything to get to, you're already performing with them. Would you say that you had an early crash course of the business side? Or was it just really studio and performing, being that you had someone from BMI, and that's publishing, that's the most important thing. You know what I'm saying?
But as a kid, right? As a kid, my mom's didn't want nothing to do with music. You know, she ain't know nothing about music. So she gave my big brother, like, power of attorney. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
So as a kid, I didn't know nothing about the business. So
of
like,
course.
So, like, mad stuff was getting, like, you know, shut down or turned down or deaded that when I look back as an adult, I would have jumped on that opportunity and took advantage. Like, I'm going to give you a perfect one. The Channel 7 morning cartoons, you remember when they used to have some rap? I wrote the verse. I got paid for writing the verse when I was like 12.
Wow.
But I was supposed to be in a commercial and my brother shut it down like, what? Oh. Little brother ain't dancing like no hammer. You crazy? What?
Son, you could have been the first Pusha T before Pusha T.
Yeah, I'm saying.
You could have been saying,
You know what I'm saying?
I'm loving it.
But we could have still did it without compromising. Like, you know what
I
saying?
Don't own the rights to that slogan I just did on air. I don't own the rights to that. Y'all cannot sue me on that one. FCC, don't come for me. But go ahead.
Yeah, but pretty much that was it. Like, you know, like, it's just like, how could I say it? Like, it was the opportunity that we could have took, but we didn't have to go that route. Like, I didn't have to get the baggie and do like him.
Right.
I could have been myself, you know what
right.
I'm saying? But, you know, sometimes you just go with what you hear and instead of negotiating, you just like, fuck that, I'm out of here, like, you know?
And especially, you know, during that time frame, which from what we know, I would say that would be like mid-90s, late-90s, about
definitely.
That time frame.
Yeah.
About to hit early 2000s.
It was the 90s for
90s.
Sure. 90s. Yeah.
I would say that was, you was in the forefront of a lot of opportunities.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So I could see how, like, you know, possible situations got passed up on because that was the beginning of it. You know, like, a lot of hip hop artists wasn't getting opportunities to write commercials, to be in commercials without selling themselves short.
Yeah.
You know, so now fast forward few years now, you went from doing shows at 11, having opportunities, writing for commercials at 12. You are now becoming Skanks.
Yeah.
You are now becoming the guy. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
You are moving forward into Bankai, you know, the Bankai hour, the Bankai realm. How did that take place? How did y'all actually even link up?
Yeah, that's a good one too, man. You can add on to that whenever you want, bro. You know
what Blue Bear. You don't have to sit there just holding up the camera. You got the best seat in the house for that one. You know, you can speak up talking to the mic though. Pause.
Yeah, me and Martha came from the same neighborhood, and he's supporting everything that I do. So I started a company back in the day named 718 Entertainment.
Okay.
Skank Studios, the first studio I had print up the CDs and everything. So, you know, after I had stopped doing 718, Skanks was still supporting me. So I was letting him know certain ideas that I had in motion, and he brought the idea about the radio station, and we said, let's go, and we're here right now.
So now, what came first, the radio station or the group?
The group. So, like, pretty much my brother, my brother caused some hardships because he got into a couple situations with a couple of the joints he produced, and he got ripped off. He got jerked straight up, you know what I'm saying? Like, he done produced some platinum records, man.
Wow.
And it discouraged him. So he kind of like, I kind of inherited the studio off of that, you know what I'm saying? So this is where I started creating my sound and putting together my label, which is Anarchy Records, you know what I'm saying? And just Bankai was created from us all working together in my studio. So every member of Bankai is somebody that's from the hood that been coming to my studio, putting it down for a minute.
Putting in that work, whether it's for themselves or whatnot. Okay, so that's what's up.
We was killing the mixtape scene hard and stuff, like early 2000s and stuff like that. And then Rusty introduced me to Keo.
Jux?
Yeah, Rusty Jux. Okay. Yeah, that's how he's from my hood too.
Yeah, I know the homie. Okay.
So when Rusty introduced us to Keo, me and Keo started working on an album together.
Okay.
And, you know, all the features I brought in was all the homies that was in Bankai now. And then he's like, I like this dude. I like this dude. Why don't we do a group? So we did the group, and then we ended up putting together the Bankai album and dropping the Bankai album before we dropped my solo album.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? And that's how Bankai was created, pretty much.
So now, so you basically saying Bankai is pretty much a collection of solo MCs that came together within a group that was already like a three-man group. So y'all like the Justice League of Brooklyn right now.
Yeah.
Y'all whole crew is like the Justice League. Okay.
Yeah, we deep.
I got you. I understand now, because I'm like, I see some of your features, and I see, you know, some of the songs that Quest played that you performed, which we're gonna get into. Yeah. And I was like, yo, I know Rusty. I know this guy. I'm like, I've heard of all these guys. I'm like, I didn't even know they were part of Bankai. And then when you did the event about a couple of weeks ago.
Yeah.
But we're gonna take a quick music break, and we're gonna come back talking about the origins of hip hop, you performing, Bankai Hour, and more. So DJ Quest, do what you do. Take that music to a whole nother level. Let's get that energy up again.
Now I done brought her home to mama, introduced her to the crew, and even though she's smart, I'm all. Now I done brought her home to mama, introduced her to the crew, and even. Now I done brought her home to mama, introduced her to the crew, and even though she's.
That's right.
I'm always trying to.
You're not too disrespect the DJ with DJ Swift.
Anything that you can't do, girl, only thing.
DJ Quest live in the set. Shout out to Skank. New joint.
To show her how I
can't keep my eyes off you.
But bet I'm coming home with flowers.
It's some smooth shit.
Girl, it's true for you. It's nothing in this world I wouldn't do. The only thing I couldn't do was keep my eyes off of you. So beautiful when I met you. It was love at first sight. So you seen them pics in my phone and we had our first
DJ Quest.
Thought that I was cheating and I wouldn't treat you right. But how's that when I be really with you every single night? I might flirt with a bird, but trust me, I won't hit her ever since.
Big shout out to Snapshots Photo Booth.
On your fingers till I move.
Live and IG check.
I can't get too comfortable just cause I gotta make some moves. Don't mean I ain't in love with you for real, baby. You just gotta trust me some more. While I'm on tour getting money, you swear I'm fucking with horse. It's time you done kick me out or have me sleeping on the floor. So getting this over.
Big shout out to Blueberry.
Wanna be with me, no?
What up, homie?
Come on, why you acting like that? You know I love you. I would never ever dare put another woman above you. Real girl, stop acting like that. You know I love you. I would never ever dare put another woman above now you. Now brought her home to mama, introduced her to the crew, and even though she's smart, I'm always trying to show her something new. She says, Skanks, is there anything that you can't do, girl? Only thing I cannot do is keep my eyes off of you. I done brought her to the snow and shows to show her how I do. We could argue, but bet I'm coming home with flowers for my boo. Girl, it's true for you. It's nothing in this world I wouldn't do. The only thing I couldn't do is keep my eyes off of you. I used to love to roam, but now I'd rather stay with you at home. Plus, you know I love the fact that you treat my kiss like your own. When I'm out, don't worry, I won't do nothing you won't condone. Just don't try to be micromanaged.
Yeah, y'all niggas know what it is. Faggot ass niggas. Yeah. niggas know what it is. Faggot ass nigga. Body your bitch. I will shoot your man in front of everybody.
Oh, this is that straight New York shit. Damn.
I will clap a fool. I learn all about guns, seeing shootouts while the kids were home after school. Let the sound hit you. Block, I block.
Remember, follow me on IG, Snapchat, Twitter, at the original DJ Quest. With you.
Niggas be fronting. To homicide, talk to that old lady.
Big shout out to Queens Finest DJ.
You see nothing. Niggas provoke the murder.
Legends in the mist.
End up getting they not.
DJ Mix, ready to see. What up, y'all?
The murder. It's no fake smiles. When it's on, it's on. Niggas that's tough, turning the cold case files.
You've got to know your enemies. You can beat him to death and he'd never talk.
Respect the DJ with DJ Swift, btfradio.com.
Allah, I don't know nobody hotter. Got me and my bank card brothers, my nigga laughing like ha ha when you spend. All I hear is blah blah like Charlie Brown. My
bitch, y'all, Tony Eclipse, aka Raccoon.
Let's go block up. Trying to run with the martyr, use a stupid mother song to shut your mouth.
Big shout to make a bite, Jay Nash. What up, wife?
Watch ya. Pussy shit ain't a game. If I aim, I'm a bust. I'm like a walking razor. Don't watch
that. DJ Quest.
I'm dangerous.
September 22nd, it goes down at Jack's Bar. Live in Long Island City, Queens. We do it for the hood.
Hold up, man. It's the great one.
Oh, we got another give back.
Great. Big cop, man.
That back to school. Back to work, whatever party.
Prime Heights.
We just have any reason to throw a party.
Yes, man. We coming. Anarchy Records.
Shout out to my brother, one of the mother, DJ Swift.
It's a no string.
Big shout out to the heavy hitters.
Respect the DJ.
Respect the DJ
with DJ Swear.
Yeah.
Chia 1111. We back in the building. DJ Quest as always. So we here with the Bankai.
Chia.
Fam. We yes, got sir. Skanks. We got Bluebeard. What's up, Blue what's Bear. Up? I keep on saying Bluebeard. Yo, my bad. Blue Bear. So now we was just talking about the Bankai Hour and some of the things that you well actually the Bankai fam, but I want to talk about the Bankai Hour and some of the things you got underneath the brand of Bankai Camp or Bankai fam.
Well, you know, as far as Bankai fam go, it's like, you know, we got dope MCs like P General, Shati, you know what I'm saying? Daddy Notch with the reggae flavor. Mm. You know, we just dropped the new Valentine project, you know what I'm saying, this weekend. And Valentine, rest in peace. He's the ghost of Bankai. He passed away. This is his last recordings right here, you know what I'm saying?
Wow.
That joint that just played was one of his joints, you know what I'm saying?
That was hard right there. Yo, Quest played like about maybe about 4 or 5 songs today. And I gotta honestly say, like, none of them is whack, bro.
Looking good.
Like literally that, none of them is whack. And I was like, oh, snap. Now, you performed one of the songs with I believe is your reggae artist. That he
Daddy
does the
Notch,
hook.
Yeah.
Daddy Notch does the hook. He wasn't there at the Origins of Hip Hop performance, but you was there doing his part, too. And you was super lit. Like, you had energy when you started, but that was like your third song or something, like a second or third song. And I was like, really? Like, you could take it up a notch? Like, you don't even do patois. And I was like, yo, he just straight jumped into the mode. And I was like, I bet. And the funny thing was, I recognized the song from your performance to me hearing the actual recording. I was like, yo, I yelled it out to you. I was like, yo, you performed that song. I gotta honestly say, y'all music has that energy. It definitely has some of that Brooklyn, a lot of the Ville, East New York, y'all definitely have
that
vibe.
Straight up Brooklyn.
Yo,
when I heard it, I was like, yo, he's from Brooklyn.
Yo, bro.
Listen.
Plus, Queens cats got a certain sound. Brooklyn cats got a certain sound. You Brooklyn.
Shout out to the Queens homies, though.
Yeah, for sure, for sure. Well, you got two Queens homies that's going to be playing some of your Brooklyn music.
What's up, brothers?
718 all the way. But what's up with the merchandise, you know, because I want to touch on that. I see it on your page. I see when y'all sporting and promoting your show. When you came out. When you here today, Bankai all the way. So let's talk about that.
Yeah, you know, shout out to all the people that support all over, man, too. Like, a lot of people support us, man. But, you know, we got everything. We got, like, shirts. We got hats. We got we always come out with new designs, too. Like, you know what I'm saying, seasonal. So we got the new Rap Martyr one with my face on it.
Oh, word.
Yeah, that's, you see it on the gram. Like, I got my face stitched in. Shit official. You heard.
I usually don't wear anything with another man's face on it, but I will rock that. Because I just want to see what it looked like with the patch.
Word.
I want to see what that stitching looked like with the patch. And I got to honestly say, you kind of go for high quality stuff because I like the four finger ring. Yeah, I like that. Brother. You know what I'm saying? You got a lot of dope stuff on there. But let's talk about Bankai Hour, your radio show. You got a lot of things going on. You have a lot of dope people up there. Let the people know what's going on with that.
The Bankai Hour is a radio show hosted by myself, Blue Bear over here, and our other co-host, Nitra. You know what I'm saying? He's not here right now. He's trying to make it. But the show is pretty much like same way with y'all. We pay homage, you know what I'm saying, to the culture. You know, like, I'm an artist first and a fan first.
Right.
But the show was like, you know, I was proposed, the show was proposed to me, and I was thinking about it, and I jumped on it. And then, like, we've been blessed so far to have as guest DJs people from Easy Mo B to M Ski, you know what I'm saying? Oh man, like PF Cutting,
like, friend of the show,
legends, you know what I'm saying? And then, same thing with artists, like, you know, we had like Blase Blau on already, you know,
definitely, he's been
we
up
had
here,
Bernadette Price,
nice.
A lot of people love, like,
and Marquee also.
Marquee, a lot of people like it's just about our whole thing is about spreading love, like,
right.
And the same way, like, last week we had the Flip the Script radio crew, so you know we definitely looking to get y'all up there on the show.
Oh yeah, definitely
rock with us.
Oh, we definitely gonna come up there and act the fool. We act the fool because I already saw on your show y'all allowed to drink up there. So we coming through, boy. We coming through in there. We gonna be turned
up. We like to start with current affairs, like y'all, but then we like to. After our interview, we like to ask the guests, like, history. We got a segment called Know Your History, where all three of us ask the guests hip-hop history questions. You know what I'm saying? And then I go into, because, you know, I'm that hip-hop savant, man. I go into the brain and pull out random classic bars anywhere from the 80s to now. And we do name those bars, man. So the guests always got to guess three joints that I just pull out the brain randomly.
Well, we're going to schedule when we are coming up so that I'll be prepared for that.
Word.
We're gonna make sure we're gonna be prepared for that.
The Know Your History part of the show is a very popular part of the show.
Yeah.
So, like, also, that's like we want to bridge the gap. Also, but you know how a lot of people criticize the young people for not knowing their history. Otherwise, in criticizing them, we also want to show them a history in a fun way. You know,
exactly.
So they
want to educate
like outsiders
them.
Also.
Right.
Yep.
So we want to bridge the gap also about our show. Bro,
that's dope. That's dope. And I commend y'all for having that segment on your show. But I'm gonna bridge my gap here. Use that segue for our other guest that's here, sitting at the table. We got Trey Lover sitting here at the table. Put your hands together for Trey Lover sitting here. We got Switch sitting here at the table as well. Now, these gentlemen are here because they have a party called Love and Fashion Party, where they actually give a platform to many different causes and events. So I'm gonna give you the moment to let the people know what is Love and Fashion and your cause.
All right, so before I even do that, I've been hearing so many music play, my guy, and you got some fireballs, real talk. I gotta show some respect to you. Your show is dope, real talk.
Thank you, man.
Thank you for having us here, real talk.
Definitely.
Real talk, for real. Our show is a charity event we do every second Thursday of the month.
Okay.
And our show, performers like yourself, I hope like you can come out and perform.
Definitely.
And we do it to raise money for a different charity every month. Mm. This month, we raised money for Sickle Cell Awareness. Next month, we're doing breast cancer. We did, like, the Wounded Warriors. We did a bunch of different charities so far. But every month, instead of, like, sitting down and getting a knife and fork and eating fancy food, we're raising funds in a fun way, more effective way that's good for our community and our time frame.
Okay.
So, come out if you guys want to support us. It's gonna be in Queens and Wild Orchid Lounge and help us raise some money for Sickle Cell Awareness this month.
Definitely. What's the address for the Wild Orchid Lounge? I would just basically say let the people know where they could come to your event. I believe it's tomorrow night.
It's tomorrow
Give
night,
them the info so that they know where they can see it.
Alright, so look, tomorrow it's being Club Wild Orchid. Wild Orchid Lounge, my fault. At 111-48 Leffens Boulevard, South Ozone Park, Queens, New York.
Mm-hmm.
But I doubt you can memorize all that. So go to my Instagram page, loveandfashion_parties. I have the flyers posted up there a million times. You can click the link on my bio. My performer right here, Switch, is a DJ and a performer. He's performing tomorrow.
That's what's up.
He performed the first time when we raised money for Wounded Warriors. And he's like, yo, Trey, I want to come back out this month and do it for Sickle Cell. So he's here to help us out this week.
That's what's up.
I'm coming out. I'm a DJ, MC, producer, actor. Shout out to everybody for Sons of Kingston and London Web Series. Just won an award and Deep Series too.
Dope.
People out there. So just over there. Oh, it's over in New Jersey. But yeah, we're trying to focus on getting people to come down to the show. And like you said, like it's Sickle Cell Awareness. And I'm going to be performing. There's a lot of other performers on the bill. And you can find out more about me on Instagram, Switch, a.k.a. Tony, all one word.
Okay.
And, I'm an old school MC. Oh, by the way, yo, that sounded really like a dope idea. I like that...
History.
That's my stuff. I'm an 80s rapper. I'm old. So I've been doing this long time. So I got a joint that's called Death of a DJ. It's like some slick Rick stuff. So I die at the end of every verse. It's kind of like a story.
Oh, that's dope. You got to email that to me, man.
I got it on Flash Rap. All right. Right now.
So we're going to talk about that. We're going to make that happen.
Thank you.
But yeah, so I also know you had another DJ in the building that's going to be at the show tomorrow. Oh,
she's right, she's sitting right
DJ
here.
Nelly, if I'm not mistaken, right? Yeah. That's her name.
DJ Nelly.
So she's going to be performing. You want to come say what up, Nelly? Take a moment, say what
DJ
up to
Nelly
the people.
She's been rocking with me for like a year now. She's one of the best DJs I've ever worked with.
Nice.
She got some fire mixes, so real talk.
Okay.
What's good?
What's going on, Nelly? How you doing?
I'm good. Thank you for having me.
Oh, man, not a problem. I mean, it's respect the DJ, so I got to show some love to the DJ for the event.
Right.
But so real quick, I just wanted to ask you, as a DJ, what made you want to do this event or work with Love and Friends? I mean, love and fashion.
Love and friends. Don't get it wrong. We still friends.
No. I was getting it mixed up with a spot in Brooklyn, Lovers and Friends. Yeah, friends and Lovers.
That spot.
So I was like, wait, Love and Fashion, pardon me.
Well, off the back, when I first met Trey, the fact that he was Guyanese like myself, that made me want to work with him even more because I like to keep my people together. Shout out to you, Guyanese, as well?
No, I'm from Antigua. Oh,
okay. we the same people anyway. It don't really matter. And he always does this for a good cause, you know, so it's always positive. I love giving back. I love helping people. So why not?
That's what's up. That's what I definitely wanted to touch on. So real quick, we're going to be closing up the show. It's close to that time. But what I want to do is have everyone go around the room, give your handle where the people could find you and where we could have you going. Oh, okay. Okay, well, that's great. We were just given 5 more minutes on the clock. That's what I'm talking about. Yes. So, even furthermore, we're going to talk about y'all. You're going to be DJing the event. Your event is going to be for the Sickle Cell. Now, with that, what made you want to do awareness for all the different illnesses? Like, what actually made you say, yo, I want to go and do this?
Because I see a lot of people that just make money and do things, they never give back. And when I see them, to me, it's like, honestly, I don't know if I can curse it, but
yeah, you can.
You ain't worth shit.
That's right, let it be known.
You're doing all this stuff, but you're not giving back to the community, so you ain't worth shit. So people like LeBron, schools and stuff like that,
right.
I commend you.
Right.
So now, me myself, personally, I have sickle cell.
Okay.
So this one for me is a special cause. And like being inside the hospital, and there's a lot of kids that were sick and stuff like that. When I talk to the doctors, I like to be very inquisitive. They're like, there's not that much funding for it. So I said, if I can never do a program, I want to find a way to intertwine having fun with giving back.
Mm.
We just started this program beginning of the year.
Okay, that's what's up, man. I definitely got to put hands and salute to you for that. So I definitely want to say, please keep us informed of future events. You know, shoot me flyers so we could post it up on our page. We could keep everything motion. Nelly, please shoot me flyers. Let me know if you got parties. That's what our page is for. We like to show support for people that are doing things and also working in the community. I'm definitely always about that. You know what I'm saying? Because a lot of people aren't even worrying about what's going on in our communities and neighboring communities unless you're within that price bracket or you live in that bracket, you know? So, again, I want to say thank you to all my guests that's up here. We're going to go around the room. Everybody give your Instagram where they can find you. You're a DJ. If you got a resident spot, let them know where they can find you at. So we're going to start with you, Nelly, and we're going to go around the room. So, Nelly, let them know.
Well, you can find me on all social media platforms at DJNELLY03. That's DJNELLY03 on all social media platforms.
Okay. Trey?
All right, for me, you can check it out on my website. It's www.lnfpics.com. Or my Instagram is loveandfashion_parties. Everything is spelled correctly. You just spell out loveandfashion_parties.
Dope.
My O-R-O-N, 2 underscores, B-L-E-U-B-E-A-R.
That's Blue Bear, for those that didn't know where that deep voice just came out of nowhere. And he just started giving out information. That's Blue Bear from Bangkok. Give that one more time, my brother.
That's O-R-O-N, 2 underscores, B-L-E-U-B-E-A-R. Blue Bear.
That's what's up. Skanks, let them know where they can find you, my brother.
On Instagram is Flowfessional. On Twitter is The Rap Martyr. And everything else is just Skanks The Rap Martyr, you know what I'm saying? And then therapmartyr.com, bankofam.com, and follow us too on Instagram on The Bankai Hour. Peace.
For those that don't know, Skanks spells Rap Martyr MARTYR.
Yep.
So just in case if you try to spell it and you can't find it like I did, yeah.
That's how you,
right, exactly, yeah. That's Skanks. So just so you know, trying to find that word, that's his personality, all right? Just that sums it up. Switch, my brother, please let the people know how they can find you.
Yes, yeah, you can catch me on just about every one of my sites is Switch, a.k.a. Tony. If you go on Mixcloud, Switch, a.k.a. Tony. Reverb Nation, I think I'm in the top 10 on Long Island right now.
Okay, nice.
And
that plug he did, right? I'm top 10.
I had to put it out there. Oh, I got a show coming up with Slick Rick, too, New Jersey.
Dope.
So I got tickets for that if anybody wants to buy them.
Dope.
And that's through Trip Squad Productions. So peace out to Tim. And shout out to Tamora Lee Jewelry. That's all the clothing and jewelry I rock. So she's very supportive of my movement. So
that's what's up.
Thank you.
That's what's up. Yo, DJ Quest, man. Let the people
right
know.
Now, check out my IG, Snapchat, Twitter, at the original DJ Quest. Follow me. See you at my parties.
You're going to be busy this weekend. Is it this weekend or is it next weekend?
This weekend I got a little sign. Next week we do a little thing at Jack's Bar. We're giving back to the community, Queen's Finest.
That's what's up.
Butch Rock, Blanquito, we're going to do it for the hood. You know what I'm saying?
Oh, snap. That's back a free party? School.
It's a free party. No entrance. You know what I'm saying? Just come, vibe
wait,
out, drink.
You're DJing for free?
Y'all never.
I thought you was giving back.
Can you go to Mickey D's and buy a meal and say, can I get that for free?
That is true. That's a valid point. Well, I just want to give a big thank you to everybody, to all my guests that was in the building today. I appreciate y'all coming out here on this rainy Wednesday. But to all my peoples that was watching, listening, just wanted to let y'all know, always be, share, and love music. Peace. We out of here, man. Respect the DJ.
Respect the DJ.
What up, kid? I know doing your bit. When the cops came, you should have slid to my crib. Fuck it, Black. No time for looking back. It's done. Plus, congratulations. You know you got a son. I heard he looks like you. Why don't your lady write you? Told her she should visit. That's when she got hyper. Flipping. Talking about he acts too rough. He didn't listen. He be ripping while I'm telling him stuff. I was like, yeah, shorty don't care. She a snake too. Fucking with them niggas from that fake crew that hate you. But yo, guess who got shot in the dome piece? Jerome's niece. On her way home from Jones Beach's bug. Plus Little Rob is selling drugs on a dime. Hanging out with young thugs that all carry nines. And nighttime is more tripe than ever. What up with Cormega? Did you see him or y'all together? If so, then hold the fort down. Represent to the fullest. Say what's up to Herb, Ice, and Bullet. I left for half a hundred in your commissary. You was my nigga when push came to shove.
One what?
One love.
Turn
one love. One love.
Don't stop. Don't stop. Facts with the real.
DJ Quest.
We got no time. We gotta do this quick.
Facts every came to rip shit. Rip shit. The hit, the hop, you don't stop. Don't stop. Dice effects with the real.
You're in the mix with DJ Quest. Queen Five.
Dice effects every came to rip shit. Rip shit. Set. Can't forget to go. Case you didn't know the flow is fat like Joe. Yo, you nigga didn't know that I'm Batman. You're whack man, I eat a rapper like I'm Pac-Man. I figured you bring it straight from the cellar. Ferella, packing more hits than Lou Piniella. I swell a nigga in his eye if he tests me. You don't impress me. Yeah, yo, books kick the rest, G. Hey, yo, what up? The crew bringing the ruckus. No doubt we's the roughest. Dream team reign supreme like a cutlass getting ducky. The dope, you can't touch the flow. It's me, the nigga with G.
G-double-O-K-S.
So say yes to bust your caliber when I pop shit and rock shit like Metallica. Stays through the hearts of them snake fake niggas. Them all up in my face, jealous of my tape niggas. So honey, shake your fingers and show me what you got.
Blow the spot.
Dice effects with the real hip hop.
How can I love somebody else if I can't love myself enough to know when it's time?
The DJ with DJ Swift. Let's go.